Your 365 account includes 1 terabyte of cloud storage. 1 terabyte is enough space to store about 200,000 MP3 songs, 100,000 digital photos, or 60 hours of high-definition video. That's a lot of storage. I'm sure you're anxious to see how it works, so let's get started. When you click on OneDrive for the first time, you will see this screen. Go ahead and click through this screen and you'll be taken to your OneDrive. You're now looking at My OneDrive. Before we dig into details, I need to mention something very important. The sync function is not operational at this time. It does not work at all on Macs, and Microsoft has promised some fixes to the Windows version. Please do not click on sync until we can report that this is fully functional. Now let's get back to OneDrive. On the left-hand side of your screen, under My Name, you'll see a button for Files, Recent, which shows your most recently uploaded files, Shared with Me, which shows files that others have shared with you, and your Recycle Bin. Just above My Name, you'll see a search window, which searches your OneDrive storage. Just to the right of that is the New button, which allows you to create a new folder or to create a new Office document. The Upload button allows you to upload any file type from your device. The maximum size for a single file is 10 gigabytes, and you can upload a maximum of 100 files simultaneously. If you have more than 100 files to upload, you'll need to upload them in groups of 100. Next to Upload is the Sync button. As explained before, the Sync button is not functional at this time. This button, labeled Open, is also not functional due to a bug in Microsoft's programming. Over on the far right upper corner is a drop-down menu that allows you to sort your files and a button that lets you easily switch between List View and Icon View. And the last button on the right allows you to review recent activities in your OneDrive. When you're ready to upload a file, there are two ways to do this. Click on the Upload button on your toolbar and select the file that you want to upload. Or locate the file on your computer and then drag it into the OneDrive window. If you want to download a file, simply select the file by clicking on the check mark just to the left of the file. You'll notice that my toolbar has now changed and has different options than before. You can now click on the Download button and a dialog box opens, asking whether you want to open the file or save it. This method will allow the file to open from your desktop computer application. If you want to open the file online, simply click directly on the file name. It will open in another tab on your browser. You can open many types of files online, including some files not created in Office 365, such as PDFs and some types of video or audio files. For example, I'm opening this MP4 video file, and it will play in the browser online. Okay, let's move on to sharing. You can share a file with your Foothill-De Anza colleagues or with people outside Foothill-De Anza, but the procedures are different. To share a file with others in our district, click the check mark next to the file that you want to share, and then on your toolbar, select Share. A dialog box will open, and you will first want to decide with whom you are going to share this file. Enter a name or an email address, and if the user is in our system, the email address will come up below. I'm going to share this file with Joe Moreau, so I'm going to scroll down and find his name. You can now add other names if you wish to share with more than one person. You can include a personal message, and when you click Share, an email will be sent to the people with whom you are sharing. If you want to share a file with someone who is not a Foothill-De Anza or district employee, all you have to do is know their email address. I'm going to put in my personal email address here. There's my personal email address. And you'll notice that it says mcon@rockmail is outside of your organization. You can click down here so that it does not require them to sign in, and you can give them privileges to either simply view or edit the document. And that's it for OneDrive Basics. Please do go to our website for more detailed support documents. Thanks for watching, and I look forward to collaborating with you online.